Steve, you were involved in the last World Cup here in 99 with South Africa, but how much are you enjoying the responsibility of delivering the next tournament here in 2019, 20 years on?
It's an absolute privilege, Isha. I think having played in the World Cup, you know, it's the ultimate goal for any cricketer to play in a World Cup for your country. And having those experiences, knowing what it felt like, knowing what it meant to me as a player, I hope we'll be able to reflect in how we deliver the event in 20 years later. Obviously, it's 15 years ago now, so things have changed since then. I obviously absolutely get that. But at the same time, you know, I think there's certain fundamentals that you have to deliver from a cricket point of view. It is the pinnacle event. It's the World Cup of cricket. So everything that we're starting now from a planning preparation point of view is actually building as much of that as we can to make it the most incredible experience for those players.
Well, at least this time you don't have to worry about getting knocked out in a semi-final. But there's still another 4.5 years to go. What are you keeping yourself busy with?
Well, yes, obviously the Cricket World Cup itself is the, I suppose, the last event that we host. We have in 2017, though, the Champions Trophy and the Women's World Cup. So not only have we got that planning and preparation, we've got these two events before that, which are huge in our calendar in 2017, to have to deliver at the same time. So we're busy right now with venue allocations, who's going to host these matches. That'll be done by the end of this year, the beginning of next year, basically at the end of the Cricket World Cup in Australia in March of 2015. It's basically the handing over of the baton. So they give us the baton. They say, right, you're the next country that's going to host this World Cup. We've got to launch our entire brand identity, logos, everything that go with it. So we've been very busy over the last year to actually get to that point where we can deliver all of this. So not only are we looking at staffing structures and budgets and all those sorts of things, but we're thinking about how we're going to deliver a World Cup with two fantastic events in 17, 2 years before that.
You talk about those two tournaments, the Champions Trophy and the Women's World Cup. You talk about all the work that goes into it. But how much of an impact do you think that will have on cricket in this country?
We hope, and we've seen what's happened in the past events that we've run in 2009, the World 2020, where we had the women's and men's event together, and obviously the Champions Trophy last year, 2013. And I think those were incredible events, and these are standalone. We've got the standalone Champions Trophy again. We saw how successful that was last year, how the countries got behind their teams. That nation versus nation is just something you can't take away from an inspirational and a follow point of view. And then for the women's game itself, just huge standalone World Cup in this country, and we've seen what's happened with the women's game and how quickly it's grown and how it's really caught on, and the numbers of young girls playing the game is fantastic, and that is one of the great legacies we see out of these tournaments.
And just turning our focus to the most immediate tournament coming up in Australia, the Cricket World Cup over there, who do you think the dark horses are going to be? I think we know that Australia, New Zealand, India are going to be up there when it comes to winning the tournament, but who else do you think might be contenders?
Oh, there's some hugely talented teams out there, and you think of the way they're playing their one-day cricket right now. Some of the stuff we've seen has been incredible. But, you know, I think it's always going to be hard. New Zealand are always up there. I know you've mentioned them, but, you know, in their home, in their backyard, they're always in the semi-finals. They're there or thereabouts. Very difficult to beat in their own turf. But, you know, the likes of South Africa, Pakistan are always knocking on the door. And you say they're the powerhouses. India, the current World Cup holders. You know, England, they've got nothing to lose right now. They've got a massive chance as well. So there's so many, but I would say the real dark horse, I think you've got to keep an eye out for New Zealand playing in their backyard.
All right, thanks a lot for your time, Steve, and good luck with all the work leading up to the tournaments.
Brilliant, thanks a lot, Isha. Good speaking to you.